This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is graphing trig functions 3. So far, we have graphed y equals the sine of x. And this is what we ended with on the last video. Y equals sine of x. I've got these 5 key points here, which you pretty much want to memorize. And this is 2 periods of this function. The domain goes from negative infinity to infinity. There are no restrictions on the x variable. The range, the y value, goes between negative 1 and 1. The period is 2 pi, so you have a full cycle between 0 and 2 pi, for instance. And the amplitude is 1. Remember, that's half the distance from the minimum to the maximum point of the graph. So even though it's at 2 spaces, we call the amplitude this height right here, starting from the x-axis up or the x-axis down in this particular case. All right, let's graph a different function now. What would it look like if I wanted to graph, instead of y equals sine of x, y equals, let's do it like this, y equals 2 sine of x. All right, so my y value, instead of being the sine of x, would be 2 times the sine of x. So now what does that mean? If I already know what the sine of x is, I would take, that's what my original function was, y equals sine of x. 2 sine of x would mean all those y values right here in this second column here times 2. So if you put in 0 for x, for instance, you'd have 2 times the sine of 0. 2 times 0 is going to be 0. But instead of redoing it each time, I already know the sine of x was 0, right? So 2 times the sine of x will just be 2 times that 0. Similarly, when you put in pi over 2 for x, the sine of pi over 2 we know is 1, and we multiply it by 2. So basically, I get to multiply these values right here in this column by 2. So I would have these 5 values, and this gives me the key points. But you have to remember, you've got your x and your 2 sine of x. So the ordered pairs here are going to be 0, 0, pi over 2, 2, pi, 0, 3 pi over 2, negative 2, and 2 pi, 0. All right, those are 5 key points. So let's graph those. 0, 0 is right here, same as the other one. That's 1 key point. Pi over 2, 2. All right, so here's pi over 2, but we have to go up to 2 instead of 1. We have pi, 0, so that goes to the same point as y equals sine x. 3 pi over 2, negative 2. I see I just labeled this wrong. That's negative 2. And 2 pi, 0. All right, so what happens is I get this graph. And that is a full cycle. It looks just like the sine function, except it's sort of stretched. Its amplitude is different, as you can see. So if I kept going, this is when it starts repeating itself. This would go up again. This would go down again. Something like that. Again, I'm just doing rough sketch here. This would go all the way down to negative 2. Back up. And down. So in blue, I have y equals 2 sine of x. Now, what's the period? The period still is in between 0 and 2 pi. That's a full cycle. So let's write that. The period is still 2 pi. But what's the amplitude? The amplitude is 2. Remember, it's the difference between the minimum and the maximum value, and then you take half of that. So that's 4 units total, right? So the amplitude is 2. Let's also write down for this one what the domain and range is. Or let's just write, the domain for the sine function is always going to be all real numbers. So let's just write down that domain for all of these. There's no restrictions on the x. Okay, but if I want to write the range down for each of these, the range for y equals sine x, it goes in between negative 1 and 1. But the range for y equals t sine x, where is that? The minimum to the maximum, it goes between negative 2 and 2. So the range here, I think I'm going to have to make this a little bit smaller so we could fit this in. Okay, here we go. A little more space. So the range of y equals 2x would be in between negative 2 and 2. So now we have y equals sine of x. Now we've graphed y equals 2 sine of x. So let me ask you something. How would you graph y equals 3 sine x? All right, so let's say, how would I graph y equals 3 sine x? So try that. Put the video on pause. Graph it, either on the same one here or on your own, you know, brand new one. State the period, state the amplitude, and state the range. And then after you've done that, take the video off pause and see how you did. All right, now if we do 3 sine x, what's going to happen? Well, if you know what the sine of x over here, again, this is the main thing you always want to remember. It goes between 0 and 2 pi for x, it goes 0, 1, 0, negative 1, 0. So all those values get multiplied by 3. I'm going to put it in. How about red? 0, 3, 0, negative 3, and 0. So our key points here are 0, 0, pi over 2, 3, pi, 3 pi over 2, negative 3, and up. And what's happening is this gets stretched even more. And there we have a little bit more than one cycle. If you were going to do two cycles, you can, you know, go down to here, go up. Okay, no, I'm not doing a great graph here, but you get the idea. So we have three, y equals 3 sine of x. The period is the same. So for y equals 3 sine x, the period, sorry, this keeps on coming down. I'm going to move this graph down just a little bit. All right, so what would the period be now? The period of this is still 2 pi, right? There's one full cycle between 0 and 2 pi. The amplitude, all right, what's the amplitude of this one? It's 3. And what's the range? It goes between negative 3 and 3. And remember, for all of them, sine x, all of these, the domain is all real numbers. All right, so let's see if we could make a prediction. All right, so far we've done problems like this, y equals a sine of x, and I did just sine x, which means a was 1, I did when a was 2, I did when a was 3. So those are all positive numbers, so let's just assume for now that coefficient is positive. What would the domain be? What are the values that x could take on? Well, negative infinity to infinity. It could be anything. All right, the range, what happened? The range went, if it was 2, oops, sorry, having technical difficulties here. All right, so if this was 2, remember it went in between negative 2 and 2. If it was 3, it was in between negative 3 and 3. So the range is in between negative a, whoops, I'm writing infinity, negative a and positive a. All right, we know a is positive, so this should make sense. The period. The period was 2 pi for all of these. And what was the amplitude? It was simply a. We know that's a positive number because it says a is greater than or equal to 0. All right. So this should help you, and then you should be able to get your key points from this. And we're going to do some problems where A is negative on the next video. And by the way, if I had let A equals 1 half, let's just think about what that would look like. What if I wanted to know what y equals 1 half sine x looks like? Go ahead and put the video on pause and see if you could figure that out on your own. What would happen then is that the period's the same, right? But the amplitude would be what? The amplitude would be 1 half. So it would look almost like this function, but it would only go up a half a space. And there we go. That's what your graph should look like. That's one cycle. If you kept on going, if you want a couple cycles, you can go over here. Now, if you're not sure in any case how to graph something, what you do is you put in a lot of ordered pairs and you connect the dots. So if you don't remember, you know, what's really going on here, to make it simple using these values, and then if I do 1 half sine x, you know, you could just plug in. Put in 0 for x. Put in pi over 2 for x. Put in pi. Put in 3 pi over 2 and 2 pi. And see if you get the smooth curve. You should get 0, 1 half, 0, negative 1 half, and 0. So you can also have fractions. It doesn't have to be whole numbers. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.